Navzi, welcome to NDTV.
Thank you.
I've been following you on social media and I see a lot of fun happening on the sets of Judwa.
Yes, because that's supposed to be a fun set. That's
right.
A fun film.
Right.
So there's a lot of fun that happens on that set. And clearly, that same chemistry and fun you're going to see on screen.
Right. That, you know, is it, I mean, a set of a comedy film or a multi-starrer is all, is it like a picnic because it looks like a big picnic?
I really have not been a part of that many multi-starrers, so to say. But yes, I think it is a comedy film. I think the best way to bring about natural comedy is to just be funny on the set all throughout. You know, you just keep that momentum of being funny going on screen, then that's what makes people laugh. So I guess that's what we are following.
Right. You know, Naam Shabana did very well. It was a film that we all were watching, going to watch very closely. It was your big role.
Yeah.
And we were, and you know, and see how well it worked for you.
Yeah.
Critics said big thumbs up and all kinds of things. So tell me, before the film, was there any kind of a worry that, you know, it's just this one is on me?
I didn't have to worry. I didn't really worry about the result of the film because I knew I'm working with the same team of babies. So it was not like I had doubts on how well the film will do. I knew it'll be good. We'll see how good. I knew it'll be good. Now, what numbers it'll make, we'll see.
Right.
But the only thing I was slightly nervous about was how will the audience take seeing me for more than 2 hours on screen, because they haven't done till now.
Right.
So they haven't seen me continuously so much on screen.
Right.
So this I was very excited to. Are they ready to take me in as the protagonist of a film or no? And that is what really I took back from that film. I learned from that film that yes, my audience can see me for 2 hours, and that gave me a lot of confidence to choose more and more such films with some interesting concepts where I can be the protagonist of the film and bring some interesting stories.
Right. You know, you're saying you don't really get worried with, you know, what is a Thursday night like? You know, what is that? Like, do you get good sleep on Thursday
night? So, I never get worried until Wednesday.
Okay.
Yeah, so Wednesday comes, and Wednesday and Thursday, these 2 days are scary for me.
Right.
So, the daytime, I am all fine and promotions and all are going on, but the moment I come back home and I know that the prints have been dispatched and it's all sorted and sealed and it's going to actually release a day before in some other countries, I'm like, okay, now it's all done.
Yeah.
Now you can't even do any changes to it. So then I start getting slightly sleepless, tense night. And what if it doesn't work? Because before that, I'm super confident that it will work.
Yeah.
Only on Wednesday night and Thursday night, I start feeling the jitters.
Do you sleep well?
My sleep is 99% of the time, always very well. I sleep for at least 8 to 9 hours a day. That has never been affected.
Okay.
Unless I'm sick. Right. But then on Thursday and Wednesday night, it's more like nervous. Like jitters. I'm having, even in my dreams, I'm like, I can feel that the day is coming and the day is changing and now I'm closer to the release. So I have that running even in my dreams.
Right.
So that's quite nerve-wracking.
And then comes Friday morning. What do? You have a big release, Naam Shabana release day. What time do you wake up? What do? Do you read reviews?
I generally wake up by 8, 8:30. So I that's what I do if I'm not shooting or if I'm not doing something early.
Right.
So I wake up and I go on Twitter. Okay, because more than the reviews, I want to see my audience's reaction.
Right.
So I go on Twitter first and slowly I start getting tagged to the links of reviews. And I know it's a very bad habit. I should not be reading these reviews because it's ultimately the audience who's to run the show.
Right.
And sometimes you're not really happy with certain reviews. But I end up reading them and something makes me happy, something makes me not really happy. But what really changes my mood is the reaction of the local janta.
Hmm. But isn't that sometimes, you know, like say for some actors don't like it. They're like, you know, this is too close to a fan. You can't tell me anything to my face.
Yeah, I mean, some there are trolls, of course, who are extremely mean.
How do you deal with that?
I block them.
You blocked them.
I blocked them.
There's never been a time when you have responded in anger or something.
I think when I came on Twitter, say 6-7 years back, I would have probably replied once or twice to someone in a very rude way. And then my father called me up immediately. He's like, this was not the right way to reply to anyone on social media. You should not be talking like this and all. He gave me one lecture. So I was like, okay, dad, fine. I will not talk. So from then onwards, well, also because of that, and then slowly I learned that the whole idea behind these shows is to get attention.
To get,
So they want this reaction. That is their claim to fame. I cannot give it in.
Yeah, you can't give them that importance.
Yeah, so that's why I have to block them, to just totally ignore them or look through them. If I reply to them or get angry because of them, it's their mission is fulfilled.
Right, absolutely.
So that's why I don't react to it.
That's a good one. And then comes, you know, then what? Okay, we were talking about, we were still on Friday.
Yeah.
So do you start tracking collections by evening? Would you be interested?
I do track collections. I, in fact, am in touch with my studios, whoever released my film, and they give me an entire breakup of the regions, how much it's collecting at different regions, multiplexes, BC centers.
Right.
So I do get an entire breakup of my collections, because it's, at the end of the day, it's showbiz. I know for some actors, it's like if they have done their job and they are creatively bent towards it and they want to just move to the next project.
Right.
But for me, it's also very important that producers are getting the money back, because then only they'll be able to make more films with me. So I do keep a track that my producers are getting the money back or not.
Right. So, you know, going forward, what can we expect? What next?
Well, I'm changing gears, as everyone can see. I'm getting into something very high octane commercial. Cannot get more commercial than this.
Not at all. Yeah,
so Juva 2 on 29 September. That is the release date I have in hand. I have a couple of other projects. We don't have release date for that in hand as yet. So I'm not making them stale by talking about them. But Jurva, yes, we have a release date. And after that, I'll again change my gears a little bit.
Right.
Because, I just don't want to do one thing at a time. Before you typecast me, I'm going to make sure I change that gear.
Good. So keep experimenting. Jurva is something I'm sure everybody is looking forward to.
I'm myself looking forward to how you guys are going to react to my glam avatar after you've seen me, like, with negative makeup. Negative makeup is because you have to make, sometimes do things to make yourself look ugly in certain films. So I've done that to myself in Shabana and Pink.
Right.
So after that, how are you going to react to the most glamorous look of Tapsee? I really want to see the reactions.
So will that Thursday night be any different? This will be a very high octane night.
Let me tell you something. That Thursday night is going to be the most calm Thursday night compared to the last couple of releases of mine. Because, dude, it's Jurva. Like, it's got Uchi hai building, it's got Tantana, Tantan Tara, it's got Jurva. I mean, what else?
How many times did you see the first Jurva?
As a kid, I've seen it so many times. Yeah. I never bothered to see it again when I signed it, because I didn't want to keep that in mind while I was doing it, because my character has been totally changed.
Right. Okay.
So that is my character is not like Karishma or Rambaz at all.
Right.
So there's no point seeing it for that.
But are you a fan of David Dhawan movies?
Oh yeah, yeah. I know all his songs. I have a playlist of David Dhawan films in my song list.
Right.
And I have playlists of David sir's songs. I'm a huge fan of his songs.
Yeah.
And yeah, I mean, till date, when it comes to his songs, then I think there's no director who's got the kind of success rate he's got with his
songs. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So this time also we can expect something.
Oh yeah, yeah, 100%. 100%. Now that you have me dancing in it, it's going to be even better.
We love the confidence and good. Keep changing tracks and doing more good work. Thank you very much.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
Thank you.